In the life of this world, human beings are responsible for overcoming the impulses and appetites of their lower selves and living their lives to please God. To do this, we have been given a very short lifespan of 60 or 70 years on average. Following the life of this world, God has created an endless and perfect life for His servants who have won His favor. Those people who have shown steadfastness and determination in displaying moral perfection and remaining as genuine servants to God will obtain a great reward in the world to come. God has created human character in such a way that he can only be at ease in paradise, the only place where the desires of the heart can be fulfilled. God makes this clear to his servants in many verses of the Quran. He reminds us that the real life is the life of the hereafter, and therefore every effort should be expended to attain the abode of endless beauty. One verse of the Quran on this subject is as follows. The life of this world is nothing but a game and a diversion. The abode of the hereafter, that is truly life, if they only knew. In one hadith, our Prophet, may God bless him and grant him peace, gives an example to show what a great blessing paradise is for human beings compared to the life of this world. A space in the garden equal to the distance between the middle and the end of a bow will be better than all that upon which the sun rises and sets. God has created many proofs to show people that the life of this world is not the true life. Starting with the body itself, one is confronted almost every day with the imperfections of this world. You may come face to face with sickness, injury, or even death because of the slightest accident. Beautiful flowers, like the human body, also fade with time. The most colorful and pleasing roses, tulips, and violets wither and die. The tastiest and freshest looking fruit and vegetables become stale and inedible in a very short time. In the face of all this imperfection, a person, in his heart of hearts, wants to live in a world where perfection is never-ending. With this in mind, he looks for ways to establish a life within the parameters of this world that is happy and carefree. However, God tells us in the Quran that this kind of life can only be had in paradise. God reveals much in the Quran about the blessings of paradise because he wants people to understand that everything they are looking for, longing for, and everything they love is in paradise. In this film, we will look at verses of the Quran and hadith of our Prophet to see the perfect blessings that our Lord has prepared for us. One of our purposes is to remind people that the real life is not in this world, but in paradise, and what our hearts desire is not here, but there. At the same time, to explain the splendor of paradise, its limitless blessings, and the good life that will be lived there. And this will increase people's longing for paradise. Of course, our capacity to grasp the descriptions of paradise throughout this film are limited by the limitations of the human mind. Indeed, the perfection and beauty announced by God in the Quran and described in the hadith of our Prophet are too great for a human being to conceive of with his intellect. Before discussing the blessings of paradise, it will first be useful to say something about some errors regarding the hereafter. As revealed in the Quran, our Lord, to whom all justice belongs, will reward everyone in the hereafter for his deeds in the life of this world. Some people, however, are skeptical about the life that follows death, about the existence of paradise and hell, in other words. This doubt is described in one verse. No, their knowledge stops short of the hereafter. In fact, they have doubts about it. In fact, they are blind to it. The most important reason for these people's doubt is that they hold misconceptions about the true nature of matter. They imagine that matter is absolute and deny the existence of anything outside matter. These people believe that only the material world exists, and since they are unable to locate paradise and hell within that world, they also refuse to believe in the existence of the hereafter. However, their beliefs about matter, which form the basis of their denial, are totally mistaken. God describes the error of such people in the Quran. They know an outward aspect of the life of this world, but are heedless of the hereafter. It has been scientifically proven that the world we experience is not, as the majority of people think, somewhere consisting of matter. Matter does exist in the outside world, but everything we see, touch, and experience is a collection of perceptions created in the perception center at the back of the brain. Therefore, we can only experience this material world through our perceptions. In other words, we can never have direct experience of the original matter on the outside. We can clarify this with an example. You are mistaken if you imagine that you are seeing the screen in front of you with your eyes, because it is not your eyes that are doing the seeing. The eye is merely an organ that transmits light reaching it from the outside. It is the brain that sees. Light rays coming from an object fall on the eye's retina. Here, these light rays are transmitted into electric signals by certain cells and reach a tiny spot at the back of the brain, the center of vision. When electric signals reach it, it sets up the image of the screen. In other words, you are seeing the screen at the back of your brain. You perceive the cup you hold in exactly the same way. The electric signals transmitted to the brain by the nerve cells in your fingers turn into a sensation of touch in the relevant center in your brain. In other words, it is not your fingers that touch and feel the original of the cup. That feeling arises as a perception in your brain. For that reason, people can never have direct contact with the original of matter that exists outside the brain. Everything we see, hear, touch or taste consists of perceptions forming in the brain. Everything outside a person, everything he imagines to be some distance away, is actually in his brain. In other words, the entire universe, the entire life of this world, everything from the stars to the flowers in one's room, are created inside a person's head. Everyone watches, touches, and hears a world that forms within his brain. In conclusion, God shows the material world he creates as an image inside everyone's brain and causes it to be perceived as reality. This account is extremely important for those people who imagine they have direct experience of the material world and who thus doubt the existence of paradise and hell. In addition, anyone who understands how God creates the world inside people's minds can also appreciate the creation of paradise and hell. That person will realize that he can never have direct experience of the original of matter in this world and the hereafter. When he realizes that everything he experiences is shown to him as an illusion, it will be impossible for him to continue denying the existence of paradise and hell just because he cannot see them with his eyes nor touch them with his hand. On the other hand, someone who grasps this significant reality will better appreciate the omniscience and glorious creation of God. God, who has created flawless, bright worlds identical to their originals, inside the darkness of the heads of billions of people for thousands of years, has the power to create paradise and hell in the same way. When a person dies, God changes his image of this world and begins showing him that of the hereafter. This is a transition, just like a curtain being lifted and revealing a brand new image behind it. Let us now speak of the subject matter of this film, The Blessings of Paradise, in the light of the hadith of our Prophet and the verses of the Quran.